There are three types of memory access that are affected by security: instruction fetches, JTAG access, and data reads or writes. Instruction fetches are always allowed, regardless of the security status of that region. There are three types of security status for each memory region: unsecure, secured by one of the two zones, and execute-only protection from one of the two zones. When a memory region is unsecure, all access is allowed, such as JTAG access and data reads or writes from the CPU. When a memory region is secured by one of the two zones, data reads are only allowed by code located in a memory region that is secured by the same zone. For example, if flash sectors 0 and 1 are secured by zone 1, any code running from flash sector 1 has unrestricted access to any memory in flash sector 0. However, if flash sector 2 is unsecure or secured by zone 2, it does not have access to flash sectors 0 and 1, with the exception of instruction fetches. When a memory region is designated as execute only by one of the two zones, all data reads and writes are blocked in that region. In our previous example, this would mean code running from flash sector 1 would not have data read or write access to any memory in flash sector 0 or 1. There is one exception to this rule in the event that a user wishes to copy code from flash to RAM for faster execution. If two memory regions are designated as execute only by the same zone, the user can copy code between the two memory regions using the secure copy code function. This is very useful if a user wishes to copy code from flash to RAM without compromising code security. More details on the secure copy code feature will be available in the advanced features video in this DCSM video series. Before detailing how to lock or unlock a device, let's establish the difference between the term locked and the term secure for the purpose of this video series. The terms secure and unsecure apply to specific memory regions. For example, RAM block LS0 can be secured by zone 2, while flash sector 0 can be secured by zone 1. Alternatively, a memory region can be unsecure if it is not secured by either zone. The terms locked and unlocked refer to when a particular zone's security settings have been activated. If a zone is unlocked, all memory regions designated to that zone are effectively unsecure and can be accessed by any user, such as JTAG or the CCS memory browser. When a zone is locked, security settings specified by the user will take effect for all memory regions secured by that zone. Any unauthorized read to a memory region secured by that zone will return all zeros. You can test this in the CCS memory browser when a zone is in the locked state. On a device reset, all memory regions except boot ROM and OTP are inaccessible until security initialization is performed by the boot ROM. Once security initialization is performed, both zones will be in a locked state until they are unlocked by the boot ROM or by the user. The boot ROM will attempt to unlock the device using the default CSM passwords. Because of this, any user who wishes to use the DCSM module must program their own unique passwords in the zone select block to prevent their zone from being unlocked on device reset. Zones are unlocked by the user or by the boot ROM using the password match flow. The password match flow is a sequence of actions required by the DCSM module in order for a zone to switch from a locked state to an unlocked state. These actions can be performed automatically using the UniFlash or CCS on-chip flash tool, but the specific actions required are detailed in this slide. First, a dummy read of all CSM passwords of the locked zone must be performed. These are located in the active zone select block. Depending on the value of the link pointer, the active zone select block may change, so the user must take this into account to determine the location of the CSM password fields on which the dummy reads should be performed. Then the user must write the values of the CSM passwords to the CSM key registers. If the values written to the CSM key registers match the values in the CSM password fields, that zone will become unlocked. Refer to your device's technical reference manual for the locations of the CSM key registers. This concludes the DCSM video tutorial for locking and unlocking device. Stay tuned for the upcoming videos in this video series for a more in-depth overview of the core concepts and features of DCSM. Additional resources can be found in any C2000 technical reference manual, as well as various application reports written on DCSM.